後期不可動、今ここに受けてください
。 Hello guys, welcome back to Ushi Gaming Channel. So this video will be about the review for Shekina. But before that, let's see today's news. Yep, we are going to get something big like in this early February, which is 1 February, 3 days from now. Yes, the Sacred Stone Memories Demonic Spearman, the chapter 2 basically, is going to come. So we can get Kudan Shitain from the rare summon and Kagura as a free unit. Okay. And we can also farm the equipment, I mean the gear for Kudan Shitain on the Sacred Stone Memories chapter 2. Love this Sacred Stone Memories update because sooner or later we are going to get Ultima, Zain, Bashini, Ahato and the other powerful Sacred Stone Memories characters. Okay, so other than that, February 1 we also going to get this, the Way to True Skill Ultra EXP. If I'm not wrong, it will give 100,000 EXP per run if it's the same one as the one in Japan. Okay, so back to Shekina. First of all, her status. Her HP is not that high because I don't use the Iron Body. If it's with Iron Body, her HP can reach 665. This one is the only one that can reach max HP. But instead, I chose Deep Focus to increase her damage. Well, I can actually use this if I want to, Iron Body. Okay, so the HP is not bad. Yeah, not too low, not too high, standard. The attack and dexterity is pretty okay, so her damage is supposed to be quite okay for a ranged character. The PDEF and MDEF, they are low. Yep. It's okay because she is a ranged character. And the agility is pretty high, 137. It's even higher than Flamel's. Flamel is only 134. It's faster than Almira. Okay, so for global, it is quite high, 137 agility. Not the highest, but far from low. And she has move 3, jump 3, which means she can move around pretty well. Yeah, even though the move 3 is a little bit too slow. It's going to be better if she has move 4 instead, or 5. Her first job is Ranger. You can start to use her right from the first job. It is good because it has AoE, which is this one, Arrow Rain. Okay, so let's start from the first one. Scouting Shot. This one has charging speed. The good thing about this one is it has more range compared to the other skills, yeah. 5 range. The others are only 4 range. But it charge, which means it can easily miss if the enemy move away. The second one is Hunter Eyes. Physical damage 100% hit, instant cast. This one is good because, you know, sometimes we can see enemies with high evasion, and this one is the solution for that. And the next one is Piercing Bolt. This one is kinda similar to Sniper's Piercing Snipe. Yeah, basically it can pierce through the enemies, penetrating effect. The bottom one is Arrow Rain. This is the AoE attack from her. It is very wide, 5-5 diamonds, and height range unlimited. That's the cool thing about this skill. And it is also 100% hit, so it won't miss. Awesome. And then, for the basic ability, I'm using Basic Fist. The goal is simple. Use Sharpening Focus, and then do any other attacking skill. Yep. You can use Sharpening Focus and then use Arrow Rain for very high AoE damage. Yeah, I don't use the Basic Hunting because you don't really need this, except you want to get the ailments like chance of inflicting bind, this one, chance of inflicting daze. Daze is actually good, yeah, daze is good. Daze is don't attack debuff. Yeah, the red things, it will make the enemy cannot do any attacking skill. And then White Barrage, another AoE. But if you are using her manually, Basic Fist is recommended. Even on auto, this one is recommended because sometimes she can use Sharpening Focus in auto battle. Which means on the next turn, even her normal attack will be very painful. If you want to, you can get Hawkeye, range +1 from the second job. Yeah, so Eagle Eye and Hawkeye. range plus 3. This will make her range very very far, but the damage won't be that good. If you want to boost her damage, it's better to use Deep Focus to get attack hit rate modifier for missile attack type. If you want her to be a little bit bulkier, you can use Iron Body to boost her max HP. It's up to you. And the reaction skill, High Trap. This is really good. This is really good. Because of, it has 4 range, and when the enemy is attacking her with normal attack, she will has the chance to inflict daze. Yeah. Which means the enemy cannot attack for 3 turns, and then she can kill the enemy. Yeah. Like, without getting any damage. Okay, this one is very good and it is very dangerous. The other reaction skills, Booby Trap, chance of inflicting slow on attacker when receiving damage. Of course, this is a lot better. Cross Counter, this is the one from the Holy Brawler. She is not made to take damage unless you are using the Holy Brawler as the main job. So this one is kinda not suitable for the Ranger job in my opinion. It is better to get the High Trap. Yeah. And then for the basic ability other than Hawkeye, range plus 1, we also have Focus, raises hit rate. I don't think we need this. Iron Body from the Holy Brawler. Guts from the Holy Brawler. Chances of surviving fatal damage. The chance is not that high, so I don't think it is worth it. Strike Mastery, this one is for Holy Brawler. So Eagle Eye, Deep Focus, or Iron Body, or Hawkeye. That's a combo. Which one do you think the best? Use it. But if you want damage, go for Deep Focus. If you want her to survive better, Iron Body. And if you want more range, you can use Hawkeye. Yeah, so it is depend on the situation. Other than that, you can also use her as Holy Brawler. Yeah, the Fire Elemental Holy Brawler. So we have Shaina for the Water Holy Brawler, and then Yomi Lucian for the Wind Elemental Holy Brawler, and now we have Shekina for the Fire Elemental Holy Brawler, which is good. Especially if you want to, you can use High Trap Reaction on your Holy Brawler. Maybe it is not the best build because most people are using Holy Brawler like sharpening focus and let the enemy attack you, and then counter attack will triple damage. But also you can use High Trap. This can be very dangerous, especially in arena. Maybe the cross counter damage won't be that high, depend on the enemy's defense, of course. So sometimes using High Trap can be even more dangerous. Well, depend on the enemy though. Okay, so cross counter or High Trap. Of course, the main ability and basic ability will be Fist and Basic Fist, Holy Brawler. And for the passive, Iron Body, Strike Mastery. The cool thing about Holy Brawler is sharpening focus from the basic ability, and then you can use Supreme Battle Trance, which can cause very 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 high damage. And also, Holy Brawler has this Define Battle Trance, physical damage, daze, and bind. Wow. And the other subs. Okay, so you can use her either as Ranger. If you need range attacker, use her as Ranger. If you need a close range attacker, you can use her as Holy Brawler. So, a unit that has 2 utility. So she is very versatile. I mean, if you need range attacker, use her as Ranger. You want a really high damage and close range attacker, Holy Brawler. Okay. So, one unit for 2 utilities, which is awesome. Kinda like Sheeta. Sheeta, you can use her as Warrior or Pirate. This one, Ranger or Holy Brawler. Her master ability is from the Ranger job. Yeah, because her weapon is a bow. And Shekina only ability, this is the master ability. If you use her as Holy Brawler, she will miss the master ability. Yeah, she doesn't have the master ability in Holy Brawler. Okay, so the ideal thing is maybe, most likely, Ranger. Sharpening focus, and then use her master ability. Boom, for high damage, long range. Wow. So I use her in arena a lot because of the leader skill. Yeah, it gives P attack 30% and HP 20% for fire units, which means she will has more HP rather than just 522 in arena if you use her as leader. Also, the other fire units will be tankier. Yeah. Okay, So as for now, since I don't have that many fire units, I am using Kadanova and Fargos. Fargos is surprisingly very powerful in arena because of, you know, when I use mono fire, it is because of the enemy is using mono wind. So the best way to counter mono wind is using mono fire. Simple logic. But if the enemy has like one water unit, do not use mono fire. Most likely you will get killed. So as for the summary, I think she is very good, especially if you can unlock her third job. Okay, you can use her right from the first job, but it won't be optimal because you don't have the sharpening focus from the Holy Brawler. Okay, once you unlock the third job, she is kinda perfect. I mean, perfect to use as a Shekinah. Yeah, she has very far range and also nice AoE, and she can do very high damage with the sharpening focus and AoE or with the master ability. That's the cool thing about Shekinah, and yeah, that's basically how we use Shekinah. Also, if you want to, you can use her as Holy Brawler. Yeah, just in case if you don't like her ranger job. So if you're asking, is she the kind of unit that is recommended to get or recommended to raise? I think yes. But the problem is, to limit break her is not going to be easy because she is a limited character. Yeah, limited edition characters don't have hard quests even in Japan right now. So if you want to raise her into 75, that's going to be very hard. And yeah, you need to be very lucky on the summon or buy her shards whenever it appear in secret shop. Of course, that is kind of like the standard way. For F2P, just pray that you will get a lot of Shekinah's duplicate whenever any Phantom of the Kill collaboration coming. Yeah, the collaboration will come several times. Even until now in Japan, we still have the newest Phantom of the Kill collaboration event. And lately, we just got Black Killer's Levatain. And yeah, I also got some Shekinah's during the summon. So, as you guys already know, we usually have 500 gems banner. Yeah, for the first step. So if you are a free player, your hope, your only hope is to get the duplicate during the 500 gem summon. I know right, it's going to be very hard to get her in the 75 as F2P, but eventually if you play long enough, like a year, 2 years, yeah, eventually you might going to get her into level 75, especially with the future features. Like we can buy her shards from the summon coin feature. Yeah, that's the other way, and also you can use fire shards to her if you really want to raise her. So the character with this kind of combo, I mean sharpening focus and white AoE, is really good in this game. And this kind of combo, sharpening focus and white AoE, is one of the reasons why Lahar, Gilgamesh, Setsuna are really good even in Japan until now. Charge up or sharpening focus, charge into the enemy, kill them all. That's the cool thing about this combo. So yeah, she is very powerful. So yes, I think that's all for now. Thank you for watching. Hope you guys enjoyed the video. And don't forget to leave a like. I hope all of you guys who press like in this video will get 5 stars. Get a lot of Shekinahs. And don't forget to subscribe for more The Alchemist Code videos. And see you again next time. Bye bye. The Alchemist Code Global Punch.